Grand Valley State University, we offer our students a course titled Photovoltaic System. In this course, students will learn fundamentals of solar cells and photovoltaic systems. However, everyone knows that you learn better by doing. Thus, we strive to give our students opportunities and to use their hands. And each year, we solicit real-world projects for our students. One of such project is to design and build the photovoltaic emergency backup system for the hospital in Malawi. And during this project, and our students first discuss the situation in Malawi with Dr. Summers, who has been working there for over 15 years.
At Mbangweni Hospital, when there's no power and children are brought into pediatrics, and they're brought in unconscious and seizing from cerebral malaria, if you can get an IV access and you can give medicines to stop the seizure, almost all our patients do well. When there's no power, there's no lights, and you're really struggling to feel for an IV or to work in the dark, many times the patient dies before that happens, and tragedies that could have been avoided, prevented, happen, and the children die.
The power outage affects our patients here at Mbangweni very much, because our operations in the hospital depends on the energy, and this is in line with operations that we do, for example, in theater, where we do procedures, we depend on the power. Deliveries, we depend on the power. Sterilization, we depend on the power. So if there is no power, it means our operations are on standstill, and that can lead to loss of lives.
I was interested in the theory and just to kind of understand, just enhance my skills in that area. But little did I know that as part of the final project for this class, we're going to design a system as a backup energy system for the poorest country in Africa, just provide a solution for intermittent and frequent blackouts. And that in itself, just being able to see a theory applied directly to help the lives of people around the world, especially the poorest country in the world, that itself has kind of fostered and enhanced my passion for that skills as I see the direct application of it.
So in a classroom setting, we tend to learn more of the theory, and it has been very rewarding learning this material and knowing that we will be directly applying it to help people in the Mbangweni Mission Hospital. And we find ourselves that in the classroom we're paying more attention than usual because we know that we're going to be immediately applying that knowledge into building a better device that is durable and helpful to the hospital.
As an engineer, sometimes you get focused on something narrow, just on your little project, and you don't really see the big picture. What you're doing has an effect on anyone else. It's just your little project. So being able to be a part of the Malawi project and being able to see how more than just my little part can affect more people, and how I can see the end of the project and see it come to fruition and help other people, has been really eye-opening.
In most of our classes, the final project's goal is just to get an A. Sometimes that means just having duct tape and string on the inside holding everything together. Here, we can't do that. We can't have duct tape and string. We know it will affect lives, and we want to have a positive impact on those lives. And that's made this a very humbling and rewarding experience.
The faculty and students at Grand Valley can continue to support campaigns that encourage corporations to invest in solar energy. Because when a better system have been built, our hospital will benefit too. We invite all students and faculty of Grand Valley to Mbangweni to do their research in solar energy. We have so much sunlight here.